In this video, we are going to learn about digestion in human beings. The alimentary canal is basically a long tube extending from the mouth to the anus. We can see that this tube has different parts. They are mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus. We eat various types of food which has to pass through the digestive tract. They have to be converted to substances small enough to be utilized by our body. The process of breaking down of complex substances into simple substance with the help of enzymes and absorbed into the body is called digestion. The process of digestion includes ingestion, digestion, absorption, and defecation. Ingestion is the taking of food into the body. Digestion is the breaking up of complex food substances into the simple substances by specific enzymes so that they can be used by the body. Absorption is the passage of digested food through the walls of alimentary tract into the circulatory system. Defecation is the passage of undigested material from the body by the way of anus. Taking of food into the body is called ingestion. The buccal cavity or mouth contains tongue, saliva, and four types of teeth. They are incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Tongue is a muscular organ present inside the mouth and is fixed at the posterior end. It has taste buds. It helps in mixing the food with saliva. It helps in swallowing and to taste the food. As we know that there are four types of teeth in our mouth, and incisors are used to cut the food, canines are used to tear the food, premolars and molars are used to chew the food or grind the food. The normal adult mouth has 32 teeth which have erupted by about age 13. If we calculate the number of teeth in adult humans, incisors are 8 in number, canines are 4 in number, premolars are 8 in number and molars are 12 in number. If we calculate them for a half jaw, they are 2, 1, 2, 3 in number. So our dental formula becomes 2, 1, 2, 3 by 2, 1, 2, 3. Digestion of food starts in the mouth. Salivary amylase or ptyalin secreted by salivary glands act on carbohydrates present in the food and convert them into maltose sugars. In pharynx and esophagus, action of ptyalin continues and no other enzymes were secreted. The soft food mixed with saliva passes through esophagus or food pipe by wave-like movements called peristaltic movement to the stomach. The stomach is a large organ which expands when food enters into it. The muscular walls of stomach helps in mixing the food thoroughly with more digestive juices. The hydrochloric acid facilitates the action of enzyme pepsin and also kills the germs present in the food. Food in the form of a soft slimy substance where some proteins and carbohydrates have already been broken down is called chyme. Now, the food material passes from the stomach to the small intestine. Here, the ring-like muscles called pyloric sphincters relax to open the passage into the small intestine. The sphincters are responsible for regulating the opening of the passage such that only small quantities of food material may be passed into the small intestine at a time. The longest part of the alimentary canal is small intestine. It is a highly coiled structure of about 7.5 meters in length. It is a very narrow tube with a large internal surface area. It is the site of complete digestion in humans. It absorbs digested food completely. It secretes intestinal juice called succus entericus, and it receives bile juice from the liver and pancreatic juice from the pancreas. Fats are digested by converting them into small globule-like forms by the help of bile juice secreted from liver. This process is called emulsification. Pancreatic juice secreted from the pancreas contains enzymes like amylase, trypsin, and lipase. These three enzymes act on carbohydrates, proteins, and fat. Amylase converts carbohydrates into maltose sugars, trypsin converts proteins into peptones, and lipase converts fats into fatty acid and glycerols. Walls of the small intestine secrete a juice called intestinal juice or succus entericus. It secretes peptidases and sucrase. Peptidases act on peptides and convert them into amino acids. Sucrase acts on sucrose and converts them into glucose. After the digestion completed in small intestine, the food to be absorbed into our body. The food that is digested is absorbed into the blood vessels in the walls of small intestine. The finger-like projections known as villi drastically increase the surface area of small intestine for greater absorption of the digested food. The blood carries the absorbed food material to different parts of the body. Glucose breaks down to form carbon dioxide and releases the energy required for various life processes. The undigested and unabsorbed food process from the small intestine to the large intestine. After maximum absorption of food in the small intestine, the rest passes into the large intestine. Here, most of the water present is taken up from this material. This material is then expelled through the anus, which is the last part of the alimentary canal. This passage of undigested material from the body by the way of anus is called defecation.